Hi everyone, very good morning. So in last class, you studied about chromosomal theory of inheritance, isn't it? So it was proposed by Sutton and Boveri. Okay. So where according to chromosomal theory of inheritance, chromosomes which occurs in pair, it means the homologous chromosomes, they always occurs in pair. One is received from the mother, another one is transferred from the father. It is nothing but the maternal and paternal chromosomes. And they get assorted independently or segregate during the formation of gametes. So, while studying the behavior of chromosomes during meiosis, okay, especially in metaphase 1 of meiosis, or usually in metaphase, the chromosomes were aligned at the equatorial plate of the cell. So, they move apart during anaphase. So, while they studying the movement of chromosomes during the metaphase and as well as in the anaphase, so they studied or they proposed the chromosomal theory of inheritance. It means the chromosomes are actually segregate or actually moves independently during the formation of gametes. They occur in pair and genes are located on the chromosomes at specific loci. Okay. And in a diploid organisms, chromosomes occur in pair and they get separated during the formation of gametes. Again, the diploid set is re-established during fertilization. Okay. So these are the postulates of chromosomal theory of inheritance that you have studied. Okay. So in this class, I am going to explain about the concept of linkage and recombination. So, and it is a supportive view for chromosomal theory of inheritance that was proposed by T.H. Morgan, isn't it? So, T.H. Morgan, who is popularly known as Thomas Hunt Morgan. Thomas Hunt Morgan. So, shortly named as T.H. Morgan. Okay. See, T.H. Morgan or Thomas Hunt Morgan, who is well known as father of experimental genetics. Father of experimental genetics. So he conducted various hybridization work on fruit fly that is known as Drosophila. Various hybridization work on Drosophila. Okay. So likewise, how Mendel has conducted hybridization work on pea plant, but T.H. Morgan, he has selected an animal, an insect that is what is called as Drosophila, commonly it is known as fruit fly. One of the reasons for selecting Drosophila is it is easy to rear anywhere in the laboratory. It means label elbekadrona Drosophila na rear madbo. It is very easy. Okay. And extensive work has been conducted on Drosophila. Especially the inheritance studies or hereditary studies or genetical studies. That's why Drosophila is popularly known as Cinderella of genetics. Okay. So, let us look at the reasons why Morgan has selected Drosophila for his hybridization work. So, one thing I said that it is very easy to rear or cultivate Drosophila in the laboratory. Okay. So, very easy to rear or very easy to cultivate. Means to rear Drosophila in the laboratory. Okay. So then shorter lifespan. The lifespan of the Drosophila is also very short. Shorter lifespan. So that is about 2 weeks. The lifespan is about 2 weeks. Okay. So shorter lifespan, that is about 2 weeks. Okay. So this is also one of the reason. And another thing, it can produce easily observable characters or morphological characters can be easily studied or phenotypic characters that can be easily studied. Easy agi study madanta phenotypic characters are produced madanta. Okay. So then another reason, a single mate results in large number of eggs. It means a single mate that can produce very large number of eggs. Okay. So another reason, the males and females can be distinguishable. Okay. And they possess the sex chromosomes that is similar to males and females can be distinguishable. And sex chromosomes are similar to humans. Sex chromosomes are similar to humans. It means males possess XY chromosome. Similarly, the females possess XX chromosome. So this is similar to human beings. Okay. So and having only 12 chromosomes. A diploid organism, a Drosophila, that is having only 12 chromosomes. So again, it is also easy to demarcate or easy to study the movement of chromosome or behavior of chromosomes, both in mitosis as well as in meiosis, and the inheritance of chromosomes from parents to progeny. So that is also easy to study. Okay. So for these reasons, T.H. Morgan has selected Drosophila for his hybridization. So one is easy to rear in laboratory, anywhere in the laboratory. Okay. So because they can easily grow on rotten fruits. That's why they were commonly known as fruit flies. Okay. So single mate can produce very large number of progenies or offsprings. So males and females can be distinguishable. So whereas sex chromosomes, which are similar to human beings like XX and XY, okay, and having 12 number of chromosomes, so that is also easy to study the behavior of, to study the behavior of chromosomes. Okay. So and it can be selected for many hybridization work, many genetical work. That's why Drosophila is popularly known as Cinderella of genetics. And T.H. Morgan, who has set a laboratory, a Drosophila laboratory in the University of California. Okay. So then, while working on Drosophila, T.H. Morgan, who has studied the two concepts, one is linkage, another one is recombination. Okay. So what is linkage here? Linkage is nothing but, so this is a very important concept. Okay. So the differences between linkage and recombination is asked many times in the examination. So here linkage is nothing but Physical association of genes on a chromosome. Physical association of genes on a chromosome. The genes which are closely situated on the chromosome. You know that the genes which are located at specific loci on a chromosome. Okay. So a chromosome can consist of many number of genes. Here, linkage is nothing but the physical association of gene on a chromosome. It means the genes which are closely associated to one another on a chromosome, they tends to transfer as such or in a similar manner. Yava manner alli physically associate agidiyo, physically attach agidiyo chromosome mele, in that same manner, the genes get transferred to next generation. The physical association of genes on a chromosome, it means the genes are closely situated on a chromosome and they get transferred in that manner or in the same manner to the next generation, or they are inherited in the same manner to the next generation. So that is what is called as a linkage. See, when linkage takes place, parental combinations or parental character is more. Parental combination or parental characters are more appear in the next generation. It means in the progeny generation or in the offspring generation, because the genes are transferred as such without any mixing or without the crossing over. So as such, they are transferred to the next generation. Hence, the parental characters or parental combination can be seen more in the progeny or in the offspring. Okay. So that is what is called as the linkage. So one condition for linkage, the genes should be closely situated to one another on the chromosome. The distance between the genes should be lesser. When the distance between the gene is less, the chances of linkage will be more. When the distance between the two genes are more, the chances of crossing over will be more. That depends upon the distance between the genes. Okay. So again, in linkage, we can classify into two kinds. One is complete linkage, another one is incomplete linkage. Complete linkage and incomplete linkage. See, complete linkage is nothing but the complete transfer of linked genes to the next generation in original combination means in what combination the genes are situated on the chromosome. Chromosome mele yava combination of genes irutho link agirutho. So in that combination only the genes get transferred to the progeny or to the offspring. That is what is called as complete linkage. Okay, the transfer of linked genes in original combination, or complete transfer of linked genes in original combination for many generation is what is called as complete linkage. Okay, because here the genes are very closely situated on the chromosome, there will be no chances of crossing over or very less chances of crossing over. So hence, completely the genes get transferred to, the linked genes are as such transferred to in original combination to the progeny. That's why it is said to be the complete linkage. Okay, so then another one, incomplete linkage. Here in incomplete linkage, the genes which are not situated very close to each other, the distance between the gene is slightly more. Hence, there will be chances of crossing over in case of incomplete linkage. They are not as such transferred for many generations like in complete linkage. The distance here between the genes is slightly more. There will be chances of crossing over here also. Then, if the crossing over takes place, there will be a recombination. It means the new characters will occur. That is what is called as incomplete linkage. Or the genes which are loosely bounded, now they are not tightly packed on the chromosome. The genes which are loosely bounded on the chromosome, or the distance between the gene is slightly more. Hence, the transfer of such genes is what is called as incomplete linkage. It means the distance between the gene is slightly more, they are loosely bounded or loosely packed to each other. Hence, there will be chances of recombination also. Such a linkage is said to be incomplete linkage. So, one thing, if the linkage takes place, especially the complete linkage, the parental characters will appear more. Okay. So, if the recombination takes place, new characters will arise in the progeny. Okay, so recombination means, main reason for recombination is crossing over. That is, you have studied in your first PUC classes. So, crossing over is nothing but, so exchange of chromosomal segments or genes between the non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosome during Packetin stage of meiosis, isn't it? So, where the genes are get shuffled between the two homologous chromosomes, especially in non-sister chromatids of, especially in non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes. Okay, so due to crossing over, there will be shuffling of genes. So then the new or recombinant chromosomes were produced. If they transfer to the next generation, the new characters will arise. So that is what is called as recombination. So the main reason between the linkage and the recombination is the distance between the genes on the chromosome. Okay, so to support this, the linkage and recombination, so T.H. Morgan, I said that he has conducted hybridization works on Drosophila, similar like monohybrid and the dihybrid crosses in Drosophila. So where in one of the dihybrid cross in Drosophila, T.H. Morgan has selected wild male is crossed with the mutant female. Here, wild male is nothing but having yellow body wild male is having the brown body and red eye. Wild male is brown body and red eye, whereas female, it is a mutant one, it means it has undergone mutation, so that is yellow bodied and white eye. So here in dihybrid cross he has selected two characters, one is brown body and another one is red eye, similarly yellow body and white eye, two pairs of characters he has selected here. So the first progeny, it means the cross between these two, the male is wild type, wild means brown bodied and red eye, whereas female is mutant type, so where it is yellow bodied and white eye. So the cross between these two that results in all F1 progeny are in F1 generation, all females are of wild type. All females were of wild type. It means wild type here, they are brown bodied and red eyed. So parents were wild male and wild mutant female. So here wild male is brown bodied and red eyed, whereas the mutant female is yellow bodied and white eyed. The F1 progeny of this cross, all females produced in the F1 progeny, all of them are of wild type. Wild type means they have brown body and red eye. And all males were of mutant type. Mutant type means they are yellow bodied and white eye. So when the F1 hybrids or progenies, when they were inbred, when they were allowed for inbred, they produces the offsprings which will be slightly deviated from the standard ratio of diabetes cross of Gregor John Mendel, that is 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. So where it is deviated from that, it is not observed here. So where it produces around 1.38% of recombinants only. It means the new chances of recombination will be very less here. That is around 1.38. Okay. So around 98.7% of the progenies will be of parental type. Parental type means brown bodied and red eye, yellow bodied and white eye. So recombinant means the new character. For example, like brown body and white eye, yellow body and red eye, likewise. The new combinations were very less. That is, the percentage of new combination is very less, that is about 1.38% of recombinants were produced or observed. 98.7% of the progenies which are produced in the F2 generation, so they resemble the parents. It means they are of parental type. The parental characters were more. It means nothing but the brown body and red eye and yellow body and white eye. So they were only the observed. Around 1.3% like brown body and white eye and yellow body and red eye. So such new combinations were produced. And they were, the percentage is very less, that is around 1.38%. So poor parental characters were more. So this indicates that the genes for the body color and the color of the eye, so they were linked on the chromosome. So hence he coined the term linkage. As parental characters appears more, then the chances of linkage is more. It means the genes were closely situated on the chromosome. As such, they get transferred to the progeny. So, adhe combination alli progenies ge transfer agirodrinda parental characters jaasti bandide. So, recombination percentage kammi ide antandre, so the distance between the gene is very less. Okay. So, in the next cross, T.H. Morgan, he conducted another dihybrid cross. So, whereas here, in the next cross, that is white eye and miniature wing. White eye and miniature wing. It means this is a mutant female. Mutant female. Okay, this is a mutant female and this is crossed with normal male. Normal male. It means wild male. Okay, normal male means red eye and normal wing. Miniature wing means having very small wings. Normal male means red-eyed and normal wings. Okay. So by this cross, in F1 hybrids, so all females will be of wild type and males will be of mutant type. It means likewise in the previous class. Okay. So whereas in the F2 generation, about 38.7% of the progenies, there are recombinant types. And around 62.3% of the progenies are of parental characters, are of parental type. About 38.7% of the progenies, so they were of recombinant types. They were recombinants. Recombinants. So there are around 62.3% or around 61.3%. 61.3% of the progenies are of parental type. Okay. So, the percentage of recombination here it is more when compared to the previous class. Previous class you compare madidre, here percentage of recombination is more. So, in previous class, about 1.38% of the progenies were of recombinants. So, here in this class, so the percentage of recombination has increased. Percentage of parental characters when compared to previous class, it is slightly decreased. Okay. So, as recombination percentage is more here, it means the new characters are produced more here. Hence, the genes for these characters, for example, like white eye and miniature wing and the red eye and normal wing, the genes for these characters will be distantly placed on the chromosome. Hence, chances of crossing over is more. Illi crossing over chances jaasti irutte. So, recombination percentage enagutte avaga jaasti agutte. When more the crossing over, more recombination will occur. It means when more the distance between the genes, chances of crossing over will be more and it results in recombination. When the distance between the genes are very less, chances of linkage is more, then percentage of recombination is less, chances of parental characters will be more. Okay. So, that is mainly due to the distance between the genes on the chromosome. By this cross, he concluded that the genes for white eye and miniature wing and normal male. It means the red eye and normal wing, so they were distantly placed on the chromosomes. It means the distance between them is more. Hence, the chances of recombination is more when compared to the previous class. Okay. So, whereas in that, only 1.38% of them are of the recombinants. Okay. So, by this, he explained the concept of linkage and recombination. Okay. So, to support this view, one of the student of P.H. Morgan, who has done a work, that is what we call as chromosomal mapping or gene mapping. A student of P.H. Morgan called as Sturtevant, okay. So, he has conducted gene mapping, it is also known as chromosomal mapping. Till today also the genetists are using this one, the gene mapping or chromosomal mapping. It was proposed by Sturtevant, so he is one of the student of T.H. Morgan. So where gene mapping or chromosomal mapping is nothing but the graphical representation of position of genes on a chromosome. Graphical representation of position of genes on a chromosome. Graphical representation of position of genes on a chromosome. Okay, so here graphically represent the position of genes on the chromosome. It means one chromosome alli genes yav positionally ide anadanna find out madantadu. That is what is called as chromosomal mapping, or it is also known as gene mapping. By this, we came to know the distance between the gene and also which of the genes they get crossover or which among them they get linked. So, yav genes linkage agate, yav genes madhye crossing over agate anadanna find out madu. That is the gene mapping. Okay, so for example, if you plot a gene map, to take an example of alphabets, for example, you think this one as a segment of a chromosome. Okay. In this segment, there are about, you think, like genes A, B, C, D, E, and F. Okay. So there are six genes here, A, B, C, D, E, and F. And we compare the genes here. You take the distance between the gene A and gene B. As for example, 5 Morgan units. Here, the distance between the gene is referred as, or the unit can be used here, Morgan units. The distance between gene is measured in terms of Morgan units. Okay. So here, there are 5 Morgan units between A and B. Similarly, compare the distance between A and C. To take this one as an example, for example, here like 8% or 8 Morgan units. Similarly, you compare A as a starting point, you compare the distance between A and D. So here, for example, you add these two, 8 plus 5, that is, for example, 13 Morgan units between A and D. A in the D gave 13 Morgan units distance in the body. So here, the genes A and D, they tend to cross over. It means the chances of crossing over between these two, because the distance is more here, the chances of crossing over between these two is more. Again, when compared with the A and E, again the distance is increases. These genes, they tend to cross over, A and E. As the distance increases, the chances of crossing over will increases. So the chances of crossing over between A and B is very less. So these genes, they tend to link. Similarly, B and C, so these genes, they tend to link. Similarly, C and D, so they tend to link. So when the distance increases between the genes, the chances of crossing over increases. So then the recombination percentage will increases. Similarly, when the distance between the genes on the chromosome, when it decreases, the chances of linkage will be more. When linkage takes place, I said that the physical association of genes on a chromosome, that is what is called as linkage. When linkage takes place, parental characters will be more. Okay. When crossing over takes place, recombination or new characters will appear. So that is a concept that was explained by T.H. Morgan after conducting hybridization work on Drosophila. Okay. So, in supportive view, Sturtevant, who has given gene mapping or chromosomal mapping, so to find out the distance between the genes, so by that, we can identify that which among the following genes they tend to cross over, or which among them they tend to link. Okay, so till today we are following this method, that is gene mapping or chromosomal mapping. Okay, so this is about the concept of linkage and recombination and the work of TH morphin. Okay, in the next class I'm going to explain about one of the most important concept, that is the sex determination, okay, or chromosomal method of sex determination. Okay.